Okay, bonus vlog time. Hello, everybody. Currently 8:30 on Sunday, the 12th of March, 2023. Now, I'm doing my fourth Mortals Games quiz on March the 17th, 2023, which I have to admit is taking up quite a lot of my spare time. A lot of work going into that, but today I'm going to focus on this. Now, this shouldn't be an overly long video. It shouldn't be. Shouldn't be. We'll see. Okay, the three areas we're going to be focused on, and the builder's going to be here tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock. Now, the first one is the most important, is the conservatory roof, which of course is leaking. It's been leaking since October 2022. The second one is a request by me. I did ask the landlady, can I have a new kitchen worktop? And she agreed to it, and the builder had looked at it, and also he did say, while we're doing this, we might as well replace your kitchen sink as well, which makes sense. And the third one was also requested by me, is down there, there's actually a plug, which would be perfect for my streaming setup. Unfortunately, that plug has no wall switch. So that's going to make it much easier if we have a plug with a switch. So the landlady has also agreed to have that replaced as well. Not many things. I will throw in a few more things along the way. But of course, the builder's going to be here very early. I've got to try and sort this place out and get the place sorted so I can get in and get out and get the job done. Yes, but of course, me being me, furniture's going to be moved. It's not going to be simple, it never is in a Mortals Games house. But this Mortals Games house does need to be sorted out. Okay, we need a starting point. We'll start here. But I have moved this once before. In fact, in vlog 15, I moved a lot of things out of the way to allow the builder to get into the property, to get the DM's work, and do the work. What I didn't realise was, just them arriving, but not to do the work, only to do inspections. I moved it all for the wrong reasons. However, this one is for the right reasons. It's the heaviest one. It's all joysticks and control pads. I haven't owned these very long, only a couple of years. I've moved them so many times. Of course, tomorrow, I'll move them all again. But there we go. But yeah, since getting this B&Q, I've moved them so many times, and of course, all of them so many times. What I did towards the end of last year, I decided to up the ante and put individual labels in each one of these boxes. I mean, some of these boxes don't have a lot of items in there anyway. It's just simple. Really simple. But yeah, joysticks, plugs, power packs, mice, HDMI cables, the A500 mini, internet cables, SCART cables, USB cables, mini controllers, control pads, C32 controllers, TV cables, mini systems, and guns. As long as I stick with it, we have no issues or worries. Yeah, simple. But yeah, that one is quite full, I have to admit. And so is that one. And that one. But I know what's in there, and I know where to find them. Cosmic. Okay, phase one complete. That'll do for now. Okay, phase one complete. Like I said in VOD 15, it's the only plug in this house. There's no individual switch, but it's just power to my streaming setup. It's a quite important plug, I have to admit. So it's got to be perfect. But anyway, I don't know if you can see, but yeah, I don't think this wall is actually flat. It's bowed slightly. But yeah, also, it squeaks when you press it. So I can probably move this house by a single push. Not good. So yeah, hopefully as of tomorrow it'll be easy for me. But yes, going to work for example, rather than turning all those off individually, just go click and make it so much easier for me. But yes, even though there's actually 8 plugs there, it's still not enough really, I need more. This room does not have enough plug sockets. But you never know, he might even put two there. I doubt it, but one with a switch is better than one without a switch. But yeah, if you put two in, that'd be a bonus. I might ask him, actually. Okay, apologies about the bad lighting, but it's actually 10 o'clock at night. But anyway, perfect timing, because it's now starting to rain. Now, if you saw 415, you would have saw that it was leaking from there to there. What makes it an absolute mystery is it doesn't do it all the time. I don't understand why sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. But also, there's a great big massive hole down there, and also over there. But I'm hoping it's going to fill those in as well. Yeah, it's a mystery. Sometimes it leaks, and sometimes it leaks loads, and sometimes it doesn't leak at all. It's a mystery. But yeah, there's a massive hole there as well. Again, don't know how well it's coming out of the camera. The other day, the next door neighbour was having his back window replaced. And the window fitter actually knocked on my window and asked me, do I own this property? And of course I don't. And he said, you do realise you've got a crack running from the top and bottom of your house. So I said, oh no, it's going to be fixed next week. He said, yeah, it's really bad. I have to keep my fingers in between the conservatory and your house. I know, it's bad. And he also did offer to do it, which was very kind. But of course, I don't own his house, so he probably would have charged me. So I decided to say, no, don't worry about it. Nice to offer though, but next week we'll get done. But yeah, hopefully you're going to fix that crack. And hopefully the house will be connected to the conservatory once again. Again, don't know how well it's coming on the camera, but yeah, even the wall is going rotten. Because it's so cold out here, and it gets so wet. But it's gone black. Not just the wall, also the floor. Massive hole there, there's a tree growing through there. Okay, 10:30. Just gone 10:30. But anyway, time for a cup of tea. I have to admit though, I don't know if I've done enough or not enough. I don't know. I mean, when it comes to conservatory, I don't know if he wants that room clear. I have no idea. Right, it's the last time I'm doing the washing up in this sink. Now the sink itself is actually not in bad condition, it just needs a good clean. The problem is I don't do the washing up as often as I should. Right. Spoon for my breakfast in the morning. Teaspoon for my tea in the morning. Another thing is, I don't know if he wants these cupboards empty or full or what. This is all... Sorry about that. Yeah, that's happened so many times in the past. I keep putting a tripod on the cooker. Trouble is the cooker's greasy and it slides off. Yeah, what I was saying is, I don't know if the builder wants these cupboards empty and that drawer empty. I don't know, he didn't say anything about that. I'm just gonna assume no. If he does, do it. But where am I gonna put it? I don't know. It's exciting, isn't it? Watch someone do his washing up. Unbelievable, isn't it? But it's got to be done. I can't have a builder come around tomorrow to replace this kitchen worktop and sink. There's loads of plates and dishes and cutlery in this place. Don't want that. Let's clean that and I'll clean it again. Alright, that, my friends, is the final time. Again, I don't know how well it's coming out of the camera, but yeah, this was a request that I made last year, and I think it really, really does need doing. In fact, it needed doing ages ago, but that's absolutely rotten as anything. I don't know how long it's been here, probably about 20, 30 years, I don't know, a long time. But yeah, along there, that's completely and utterly rotten, completely. And that bit there as well, look at that. So yeah, I don't know if he wants it empty or not, he hasn't said anything. If he does, I'll do it tomorrow, but I'm assuming he doesn't need it empty. But yeah, it's bombarded by so much stuff. When you've got limited amounts of space like I have, I've got to make do what I've got and just fill it up whatever I can. But I have put shelves in place and boxes just to try and save some space. And it did to a point. It doesn't last long, it's full up again. But yeah, I'm assuming it'll be all right. Maybe that, I'll just take that off. No big deal. So yeah, you might want that empty or just take it off. But yeah, it's crazy. It's the only drawer I've got in this kitchen. It's the only one I've got. Even that is loose. But yeah, it's just really bad quality. It needs a clean as well. It needs a coat of paint. In fact, this whole entire house needs a coat of paint. Everywhere. So yeah, it's literally just the last few bits now, and yeah, I don't know what else I can really do, to be quite honest. I mean, they didn't... Oh my lord. They didn't say what they actually wanted me to do. I'm just using my initiative, really. There is a pair of scissors on the living room floor. Me. The other day, I bought myself the latest Retro Gamer, and it took me 5 minutes to decide whether I actually had it or not. It's been a few times in the past I bought one, then gone to the shop later in the month and saw it again. I can't remember if I bought it. I bought it again and I ended up with two. But I was looking for the pages to see if there's anything I recognise, but I risked it for wearing biscuits. Turned out I didn't have it anyway, so there we go. Okay, still going. Midnight. I know, crazy. But anyway, I totally forgot about this, but yes, this has also got me clear, so I've got to try and find places to put all this. Now this toaster hasn't been moved for so long. It's confirmed about the multiple amounts of crumbs that have fallen at the bottom of it. And a lot of these ones, you do actually have a little bit you open up out there. Look. It's crazy, I've had this since the first day I moved in, and I have never ever opened these. This is going to be absolutely full to the brim. Oh yeah. It's a clean one, anything. My lord, they ain't moving. I have to admit, I was expecting to be more than that. A lot more than that. That's more like it, that one. Right. Yeah, that's the one I got used the most. Not great, but better than nothing. Again, this has not been moved since the day I moved in. This is actually a spectrum. It's actually probably the cleanest part of the house. There's nothing here. I love the fact this has been here for so long and I've never cleaned underneath it. Now the day before you get replaced and clean it. Right. Microwave in the living room. As you do. Right. Well, I think that'll do. It's currently 12:30. I mean, it's crazy, I know, but there we go. But I wasn't sure if he was expecting me to do this. I wasn't sure if he wanted me to do this, or he was going to do it. But if he was, then I've helped him out. But I don't think this is going to take overly long anyway. He did say it's going to be quite an easy one to do. Right, so that. That. And that. I think we're good to go. Okay, next day is the morning of the build. They should have been here at 8 o'clock. They're not here yet. But that's not a bad thing because I actually overlaid this morning. I got into bed last night and before I'd even set my alarm and turn off my bedside light, I was already out. And I actually woke up about 1 minute to 8. So there we go, I haven't had breakfast yet, haven't had a cup of tea yet, but yeah, they're not here yet. But also what concerns me is it's windy. That's my alarm. Huh? That's not an alarm, that's a reminder. Which I set about a month ago to remind myself the day is the day of the bills. So this is what he's going to be replacing today. I can't remember what it's called, but I think it's made of lead if I remember rightly. But yeah, it's got a split there. There's another split there. But yeah, it pretty much leaks the whole entire length. There's another one there. So yeah, that's what he's replacing. And hopefully fixing the cracks in the wall. Hello.
Good morning, Jamie.
Hello, come in.
How you doing?
I'm good.
Good, good. Day's the day.
Yes.
And Chris in the village way soon.
Alright.
I think he's doing a bit out the back, isn't he? The pointy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right, just lay this down.
Do you want a drink at all?
Oh no, I'm good at the moment, thank you very much.
Yeah.
Have you got a drink? Because also we're going to be No tap, no kitchen.
No, I haven't actually.
Don't you want to prepare yourself on before?
Yeah, I might even
disconnect everything.
Yeah, it's fine.
I'm going to grab some tools.
Has everything good?
Yep, all right. Hello.
Hello, cat.
Got it.
Yeah, I thought, oh, Pete ain't going to get there early, so I thought I'm not going to rush. Typical, that, isn't it?
Terrible when the ass is being pulled apart by strangers, isn't it?
Yeah. You managed to get what you needed?
Yeah, I think so, mate. Thank you.
Okay, currently 4 o'clock, Sunday 26th of March 2023, and I've decided to make this video vlog 16. It was originally going to be a vlog just based on the building work, but there's things I want to try and do to the property, which again requires more drilling, moving stuff around. Yes. So, I'm going to make a start in here. Now, you might have seen on some of my recent vlogs that yes, my CD collection, which of course I had for many, many years, is now in my wardrobe. In fact, my wardrobe is not really for storing clothes. But I want to change that. So my biggest problem in here is clothes. I just don't have anywhere to put my clothes. Now, of course, my wardrobe is no longer a wardrobe. There's only a few shirts hung up. I don't have a lot of clothes anyway. But the trouble is, because I've got nowhere to put anything, they get dumped. So there's a few bits of clothing there. There's some here. And some have just been dumped over there. In there is my CRT. But clothes just getting dumped on the top. I do have a shelf at the top, which has got some clothes on there. But not enough. In trouble, they keep falling down. And also, 9 out of 10, I can't get to the wardrobe anyway. So what I'm going to try and do today is have a little bit of alteration. So of course, last year I made alterations to the streaming setup. And yes, the desk is here. It can't go anywhere else. The room does not allow me to put it anywhere else. But yes, the door is always going to be a big problem. Even though it does actually open to 100%. But 9 out of 10 is something in the way. Like the headphones. I don't have anywhere to put my headphones. I want to put a hook on the wall. I have got one, so that's going to be a later thing as well, but yeah, it's dumped. But yes, it does open to 100%, where there's nothing constructed in there. The trouble is, 9 out of 10, there is always something there. So yeah, it's always been a problem. This rail isn't the greatest rail. I've moved it once before. This shelf, which is not the greatest of quality, I've raised up to make more space to get these CDs in there. But as a result of that, there's not really a lot of space for my clothes, but up there is where I'm putting some of them. But it's a bit of a stretch to reach it, and also sometimes I keep falling down. But, you know, up here I've got blankets and my hoodies for the winter, but it's taking up so much space. But if I can't get to the door, or I can't get to the clothes, that's where I get dumped. But yeah, it's a problem. It always has been, always will be. But yeah, even here, there's clothes here, now either they've actually fallen down, or I couldn't open the door wide enough to get up there. But yes, it's just an issue. But I've got to do something about this. But yeah, here there's two tables, got a mod screen there, got an old chair, and my CRT, which of course is provided by so many clothes. And shirts. I mean, there's another green screen there, there's another hoodie there. It's bad, really. Okay, this is the plan. Now, this rail got moved back further last year to allow for more space. But as a result of that, it eliminated the space for clothes. In fact, there's not enough space for a coat hanger alone. So, what I'm going to do, I'm going to move it forward and put it back there to allow clothes to go in front of it. And this is the thing, you know, the doors can be closed anyway. I can't see them unless I'm looking for a specific CD. So what's the problem having a few clothes in front of it? There's not a lot of them anyway. If we want to find a CD, we'll put one back, slide it to the left, or slide it to the right. It's no big deal. Also, that will then clear up this top shelf because I'll be hanging up my goodies once again, and I'll use that for additional space. There's boxes under the stairs that I'm going to put back up there. To allow to do something else. About a month or so ago, I put a nail there and a nail there to allow me to hang up two other hoodies just to save space. So it just makes more sense. I mean, I can't look at the CDs 24/7 anyway, so what's the big deal? I'm not getting rid of them. What's wrong with them having clothes in front of them? Another thing I want to try and do in the future also is put a light in there, because sometimes I'm trying to find a specific CD, I can't see them. It's so dark. I mean, this is the old one. As you can see, it's not flat, but also it's not the right size either, really. I'm sort of thinking now, maybe get another one, but cut it to the actual size of this beam. It's like that much short. You know, the actual width of that shelf alone is 46 centimeters, but the length of the beam. So yeah, the shelf is 46 centimetres, the beam is 61. So would it make more sense to get one cut to that size? Right, so I'm going to move this to there. Yeah. We'll be right back. Right, I'm not going to move it forward very much. Put a piece of timber there and two shelves. That should give me enough gap. Enough gap for a coat hanger. Right. That's the spirit, Jamie. That's what we need. Spirit level. Right, so put a piece of wood there and two shelves, and hopefully that'll give me enough space. Right, I bought myself some more plugs and screws. These are hopefully going to be the right ones for this type of wall. So there'd be a lot of weight on there. Well, ish. Oh, I've lost one already. There's not the ones I want at the bottom. So far this chair has not fallen beneath my feet, because it is actually a fold-up chair, not a stand. In fact, it's squeaking. That's not a good sign. Hopefully this will work. I mean, I think the screws could be a fraction longer, if I'm honest. Right, we are using the phone as my camcorder, that's died. I've just bought a new one on Amazon for £198. That was one expensive bracket. That cost me 200 quid, that one. But anyway, yeah. I mean, it's done all right. It's lasted a lot longer than I expected. The camcorder, not that bolt. Hopefully that'll be there for ages. Right, unboxing time. Now we're still using the phone because of course it doesn't work anymore, but done very well. Knife. Okay, unboxing time. We're back in business. This is hopefully going to be my camcorder, which cost me quite a lot of money, but it's something which I guess we need. Good thing that was empty. Right, and it should be exactly the same design as the one I've been using for the last 5 years. It's a Sony. Right. There we go, Sony, fantastic. It should be exactly identical, like I say. But yeah, this one I got in 2017, bought it originally from Argos. It's done very well, but unfortunately, it stopped working. Is it the same? There you go, I've actually got the original box and the original camcorder, but there we go. But yeah, it should be the same. A HDR CX450. No, it's different. 405. Oh. Okay, I'll give it a try. What worried me though is on my old box, it does actually say on there a 5.1 channel microphone. And this one doesn't say anything about a microphone whatsoever. I've had a lot of bad experiences with microphones. But I've just looked online and apparently you can't plug one into it anyways. I'm assuming like that one, it's also going to be inbuilt. But I don't think the battery's going to be the same. So that's also going to be more money to spend. We'll see. Well, there we go, superb, but unfortunately, yes, it's different batteries, so the ones I've got don't work. So we've got to spend more money. But in the meantime, we'll charge it up. Okay, testing 1, 2, 3. Any good? Does it sound better? Does it look better? Is it clearer? Is it sharper? Is it blurry? Is it darker? Is it brighter? Let me know in the comments box below. Seems okay from this end. Okay, so what I've been doing while I've been waiting for my camcorder to arrive? Well, I've just bought myself 2 new batteries and a new charger. It should arrive tomorrow. But in the meantime, the rail has been successfully moved forward and there's plenty of gap there. So, yeah, not a big deal. But the clothes are now there. Not all of them. I didn't have enough coat hangers. So yesterday with the B&M, bought myself 10 strong clothes hangers. That should be plenty. But yeah, so we'll try and put a CD back. We'll get a CD out. And it's on this side. Just slide them across. It's no big deal. No problem at all. But yeah, there will be a light here in the future. Okay, so the top shelf now has no clothes on it whatsoever. It's clear. Which is why now I've put my board games back up there. But yes, they're big, they're bulky, but not overly heavy. And this left section is also clear for the next part of this video, which is of course now under the stairs. Yeah. Okay, we're now officially under the stairs, and this is going to be sorted out once again, but this is actually a very handy little area. This is where I store a lot of my big and bulky stuff. But yes, I've sorted it out so many times, but yeah, it's that time again. So yeah, it's a little bit cluttered in here at the moment of time, but anyway, over here there are some boxes. Now these, which you probably can't see, are hopefully going to go on that top shelf. But what's going to go in its place? Well, I bought another one of these. The trouble is, that one's going to have to be shortened, because of course we have the roof here, which of course is sloped. So it's going to be knocked down from a 4 to a 3, basically. And again, I'm going to try and use it wisely, but also what I must do is sort through these once again, and put the things which I need the least amount of time at the furthest point, the things I need most at the closest point. And that's one of the things I keep doing, I keep delaying it, I keep putting it off. Another idea I thought of the other day, even though I did go to B&Q to go and get it, they were shut. Now these aren't technically flat, it's all dips. And of course it's plastic, but I want to try and get a piece of wood cut to the length of this to basically make it a shelf, make it more flat and more better. In the future, of course. Connect. Safety shoes. Yeah, it's a bit of a mess. Okay, lampshade. Pool table. Someone's gone upstairs. There's always big and bulky stuff, difficult to store. Clock. Right. CT4. Never ends. Never ends. See, stuff like this, I mean, it's handy to have, but I just don't use it nowhere near as often as I should. But it's basically for Xbox. I very rarely go online to play Xbox. Now one day I might actually have this permanently on display. We're going to actually use it. It's been in its box for years. Basically, it's a light. It's a Super Mario Bros. Collector's Edition question block light. Battery. Has it got a battery in it? Maybe. Oh god. Hang on a minute. I'm pretty sure there is a battery or batteries in there, but probably not been in there long enough to cause any concern. Also, it's not the right size screwdriver. But it's working. After all that, no, there's no batteries in there. But then you don't technically have to use them, you just use the power supply. Not a very long cable though. There you go, superb, brilliant. Yeah, I bought that from Ipswich. Hawkins Bazaar? Or, no it wasn't, it was oh, what's it called? Yes, Menkind. I just had to search the internet. It was bugging my brain. But yes, bought it from Menkind. So there we go. I'm going to put it back in its box. But maybe, just maybe, one day, it might be on permanently on display. Well, in the meantime, I've got the space. Again, it's not heavy. I think that'll do. I think that will do. Superb. Right, so it's a little bit tidy in here now, but still a few things which are still unfinished. Now, I bought this table as a temporary table to finish off a video I've been working on. I bought that on Facebook for 15 quid. That's another project. This is the current project. Yeah, I bought this from B&M, and it's actually gone up in price now. It's now 22 quid. Everything's going up in price nowadays. Okay, there's some brackets, some nails, that's for something else. Right, so even though I paid £22 for this thing, it's a 4-tier storage drawer, but it's not anymore, it's going to be a 3-tier. So yeah, unfortunately I've got to reduce it, but it's the only way I can do it. That should just pop off, hopefully. I hope it does, it should do. There you go, put a bit of a fight, there we go. So now it's officially a 3, but it needs a top. Don't break it. Ow! Ow, pinch my finger in the process. Right, take that out, Jamie, don't need that. Unfortunately, you don't. But I suppose it's not a bad thing, you know, if it one breaks for any reason. Don't break it. Ow! Again! Don't break it. Right, hopefully it should just fit back on. No problems. There you go. Boom pow! In space of about a minute, it's gone from a 4 to a 3. Hopefully it won't be affected by the ceiling. Otherwise, it'll go to a 2. Okay. Whoa! He dropped it. Right, before we do anything, let's clear this up a little bit. So those are floppy disks. They go in the floppy disk box. Right. That I didn't use. That I didn't use. That's for the quiz. Bought those from the expo. And I really like them, they're really cool, but they should be on the wall, but I've got nowhere to put them. Nowhere to put them whatsoever. Maybe in the future, I might have space. Not yet. Yeah. No, that's a bit better. However, putting a shelf here means, of course, it could be high up. So let's check that, actually. Get a rough idea of what sort of height we're looking at here. Will that go under there? God, blimey, only just. Look at that. Yeah. However, there's two broken keys in there. Or pliers. So yeah, I've had these for absolute years, but unfortunately, yes, the keys were only made of plastic, but luckily when they snapped, it was in the unlocked position, not the locked position. Only two more things remain, and we're clear. There's my toe meat games, which of course I did a video on, which of course now work perfectly. Right, we're clear. It's random, I know, but the random the better, I think. How am I going to do this? Come on, get it in. Doesn't fit. Oh, it's very close, though. Probably like a cat's whisker. Right, move it down a fraction. Tiny fraction. It's gripping on the carpet. To make this possible, I think I'm going to have to move that one left to then be able to get... I don't know if that's actually done anything. Has that moved? Not really. Only just. My lord, only just. I knew it was going to be close though. I didn't know it was going to be that close. Right, that is so close, but it's in there. But yeah, down there, there's probably enough space, probably one individual drawer, which of course I have got, but I haven't got a top. But that is seriously making the most of the limited space, that's for sure. Apologies about the bad lighting, but there we go. Three completely empty, ready to use drawers. If I want to, there's a space down there, but I don't know what I'm going to use that for, but I will definitely use it in the future. Okay, next day, currently 3 o'clock in the afternoon, Wednesday 29th of March 2023. I probably spent the last 2 or so hours trying to sort out underneath the stairs, trying to make some more space and sort out those drawers once again, and now I've got more space in here. Down here used to be my PC games. Now, I'm not going to get rid of them, I do like them, I do like having them, but I don't use them overly much. There's no point in being here, so put them in the drawers. So anyway, got some of my duplicate Amiibo boxes here, some random DVDs, and all these bits of bottom ends currently lying on the floor. I'm also sitting on the floor, so hopefully I can get this sorted out. After me, I don't quite know where to begin, but I think we'll start with Amiibo games. But yeah, a lot of these are duplicates due to ones being crushed over the years, which I bought again. Not all of them, some of them are bundles. This one, for example, Night Shift, got 3 versions of that one. That one got really, really badly crushed. My mum's loft there, so I bought it again. Which also is a Kickbox version, which is a lot better in condition, that one. But also I bought another one, which is not a Kickbox version, that's currently there on my shelf. There's Mortal Kombat, I've got 2 versions of that. Super Frog, got a couple of versions of that one as well, that's there. Thomas Tank Engine and Friends, of course, the long player of that is there. It's there because I haven't got space for it on the shelf in there. Championship Manager 93, I'm not overly good at management games, I have to admit, but that one was given to me by one of my friends from school, his name was Michael. Body Blows, again, I bought that one again because that one's got badly crushed over the years. Apologies, you can hear the washing machine. There you go, your finest hour. I was talking to Mr. Spud about that one on Discord the other day. I'm not great at Flight Sims, but I bought that one from John Stone. Zybots was donated by Heath from Man Cave Hobbies, thank you very much for that. But yeah, quite a lot of my small box versions are on the floor down here. They are safe and secure, but they're not where they should be. I need more shelves. Days of Thunder was donated by Rusty James. Nightbreed, got 2 versions of that. One was donated by Rusty James. Shadow Beast 2 and Kid Gloves, which of course I got a big box version as well. Super Skid Marks, again it's in here, so I've got space for it. There we go, that's also on the CD32. There you go, Bobo, Stir Crazy Bobo on Amiga. I've got 6 versions, I've got 5 big box versions, one's in there, and also got a small box version. The reason why I've got so many, for some reason the discs always kept crashing. Bought them on eBay, played it, and after a while it stopped. I bought it again, and again it stopped. It was a mystery, I don't understand why, but it just kept breaking. There you go, these are some of my South Park DVD box sets. The reason why they're in here, because the boxes were too big for the shelves. But yeah, these cost me an arm and a leg, these are really expensive. That's actually still sealed. The reason why they cost me so much money is because they were discontinued, and I really, really wanted them. But eventually, over the course of time, they actually re-released them in a different box set altogether. So yeah, probably did spend quite a lot of money on that one. But again, why not? Because it's something you can't get anymore. So anyway, instruction manual for my Hoover. I got the PlayStation 3 on launch day, even though it was a really expensive day. I didn't play the PlayStation 3 nowhere near as much as 1 and 2, but I haven't got a lot of games, I've got some. But there's Metal Gear Solid 4, Time Crisis 4, some of these are sealed. Motorstorm, Pacific Rift, that's sealed. Pain, that's sealed. Ratchet & Clank, Quest for Booty, that's sealed. I never got around to playing them. Motorstorm, that one I have played. Throwaway Challenge is also sealed, bought it from Electronics Boutique. Ratchet & Clank, A Crack in Time, that one I have played. And Grand Theft Auto 5, that one I also have played, but only a few times. But yeah, not many, I have to admit. Most of these I have played though. That one I did finish, Ratchet & Clank, The Tours of Destruction, I was talking to Mr. Raw about that one. That's fantastic. Little Big Planet Karting, bought out Ipswich. Ridge Racer 7, Resistance Fall of Man, haven't gone back to that one for ages, I just must finish it. Little Big Planet, I do like that one. Uncharted, Mr. Raw, would be a fan of that one. I've never played 2 or 3. Killzone 2 and Resistance 2. I think that is also, it's not sealed, but it's only played a couple of times. But yeah, I did spend a lot of money, but yeah, I didn't play it nowhere near as much as others. Now when it comes to Blu-rays, I don't have many. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I've got 13 Blu-rays. The trouble is, you buy them on video, you buy them on DVD, I don't want to buy them again. I just don't want to buy them 3 times. So that's why I stick with DVDs. another one there, Super Fighter, that was also donated by Rusty James. There you go, one of David Ginton's favourites. There you go, Wise of the Robot, got two versions of that one. Final Fight, that one got really, really badly crushed. In fact, it's probably one of the worst ones I've got. That's creased there and there, there and there. Terrible state. It's a good game though, but caused a lot of disswapping. But yeah, the box has seen better days. A few more games up here, there we go, Thundercats. Love Thundercats. There are one for Dazman 79, there we go, Shuffle Puck Cafe and Grand Monster Slam. There we go, got Wiz as well, that came out a few years ago, not played it for a while. Wiz, the Chris for the Magic Lantern on me. There we go, Lotus 2, bought myself a mint box version last year. That is also not in the greatest of quality, but of course, me being me, I'm not gonna sell it, I'm gonna keep it, because I love it. Right, what I'm going to do, is I'm going to put the big box versions there, small box versions we put there and maybe there. But yeah, these retro gamers, you probably can't see. But yeah, these retro gamers have been collecting them pretty much from the start, but it's free, full to the brim shelves just on retro gamers alone. But yeah, so much weight there, but yeah, I don't get round to reading them really, so I keep thinking to myself, is it really worth buying them? I don't know. Okay, next task, currently... Actually, no, that's wrong. Clock's a bit forward, didn't I? It's actually 10 to 5. Not 10 to 4, that was my phone. Okay, so it's 10 to 5. Next task is this. In fact, it's this one, not this one. What's wrong with it, you say? Well, the backing of this one, for some reason, actually come away from the unit. So when I'm putting a DVD on the shelf, it's going back further than it should. So yeah, this is a job I've been meaning to do for quite some time, but I keep leaving it, because it's never going to be simple. I don't even know how bad it is. I have no idea. Interesting though, it's not technically missing them because it wasn't there to begin with. I'm assuming it was me to put this together, but I have had this a long, long time. But there's one there, and there's one there, one there. There's none there whatsoever. In fact, this whole entire section has got no nails at all. On this side, it has. I thought this would take ages. It shouldn't do. It just needs one there, and probably there. I'll probably put one there as well, because it's also a little bit flimsy on this side. But yeah, there's not many on the inside there. On the outside, there's loads. But anyway, I bought myself some more nails, B&Q. I've gone for 1.6 by L20 millimeter. That'll do. Right, so what's on the other side? I'm gonna put a hole for a DVD. Alright, it's Xbox. So about there. Don't hit your thumb or your finger. There we go. The trouble is now I've closed that gap, it's difficult to tell where the next one's gonna go. It will go. And these DVDs are also in alphabetical order, which is why I didn't really want to take them all off. Just have a lot of work to do. In fact, the only things that are not in alphabetical order in my house is my Mii games. CD4 games are, PlayStation 1 games are, PlayStation 2, even my CD32, and of course the CDs. CDs took the longest. Yeah. Who's ever hit their finger or thumb really hard with a hammer before? I have, but not really hard. Not to give myself a black fingernail or thumbnail or anything like that, but I have dropped a concrete slab on my toe before. Eventually, my toenail fell off. Yeah, it was pretty bad. Alright, be careful with this one, Jamie, because on the other side of this is your CD32 games. And a CD should only have one hole in it, the one in the middle. Well, that didn't take overly long at all. What a surprise. Well, there we go, what are you doing? Ooh, my lord, all that dust. Mum said to me one time, why don't you put these underneath the stairs? No, I'm not. There's no room under there. Can't watch a DVD under the stairs. Well, you can. Why would you? Resume play today, 7th of April 2023, currently called the 7. Right, this has actually been in my porch for about a week. No word of a lie. But anyway, this is the next project. Okay, so the next area I want to try and sort out is this porch. It's a dumping ground. So it's not the easiest thing to record though. So yeah, this is not going to be easy to record, and it's been a dumping ground for absolute ages. But yeah, in here some boxes, Jasper's boxes there, some safety shoes, a fan. More shoes here, a coat, a garden spade. Part of my streaming light is in here. There's a bottle of oil in here. There's a scarf on the floor, a bicycle pump, a football pump, even a football in here somewhere. Spirit level. Yeah, and other few things as well. But anyway, the most important thing is, the biggest bulky thing in here is my lawnmower. But yeah, every time I want to try and get to something, like the fan or the lawnmower example, I've got to take everything out. So yes, this is the idea I've got, to try and clear this out and hopefully make it look a bit more presentable. Which brings on the subject of this bad boy. This is a Cadbury deck box. Bought it from B&M, cost me 60 quid. Bought it a week ago, so I'm finally going to put it together. But yeah, this is hopefully going to be the answer to my problems. But yes, hopefully everything from in there, or as much as possible, will go in here. It goes in your garden, also it's a seat, and it's water resistant. Now, it wasn't the simplest thing to get hold of either. In fact, I went to 4 different branches, B&M branches, to get hold of one, and the only place I saw one was Folkestone. And me being me, I didn't get it when I had the chance. I saw it and I thought, right, I'll get it on the way back. I'll go upstairs and get something from up there. I spent too long up there, came back down, and then someone took it from literally underneath my nose. So yeah, I've always done that. I must make sure you get it when you have the chance. Don't leave it, you might regret it. In this case, I did. So what I did was, I had to go back in a few days' time, get it when it was back in stock. But yeah, if I was 10 seconds earlier, I would have got it. It would have been... And also, I'm going to the tip tomorrow, so hopefully all this cardboard is going to be taken away. Right, but yeah, it's plastic. But yeah, apparently it takes 20 minutes to put together. Instructions. Right, okay. Superb. Right, so trouble is, once again, it's spice. Should be fairly straightforward. He says. So we need that. We need that. Right, that's together. Same for the other sides. Wet here, why is it wet here? Right, now we need the base, the buttery biscuit base. Where is it? There you go, it looks a bit like Phantom Mega's coffin, doesn't it? He deserves better than that. That's back to front, Jamie. Or is it? No, it's right. Hinges out. James is on page 4. Right, so there should be two of these. Check. Goes through there. Really? All about that? Put a door on, baby. That'll help. Right. Back on. I knew that. And that goes in there like that. Right, here they go. It's all got in there over time. It's a random tripod, fan, a slow cooker, and a random scarf. But that is superb. so much better. Okay, it's currently 10 to 8. However, one more thing remains. Okay, the final piece is this. And which beings you wear on today? This one cost me 20 quid, I think it was. Got it cut down to size professionally, and it should be the exact size of it now. Okay, it's currently 20 to 10, Sunday, 11th of June, 2023. Right, the final piece of footage for this video is another purchase. It's out here. Okay, nearly as tall as me. Okay, so what we have here, my friends, is my new green screen. And this one I bought from Amazon, cost me £124, took about a week to arrive. The reason why it's so expensive is it's got Elgato reel on the side of it. But yes, of course, I've had a lot of experiences with green screens, but hopefully it doesn't solve all the problems I've been experiencing. Okay, we'll start at the beginning. Now, since starting the channel, I've actually bought, including this one, 5 different green screens. And the first one was absolutely horrendous. The material was not the right material. This one has been good. This one has been modified. Mum put it onto a curtain rail and extended it for me. It's been brilliant. And since I moved my streaming setup from here to there, I decided to leave it here. Never know, in the future I might need it. But it's been good, it's been really good. And of course, being on the curtain rail, it doesn't fall down anymore. Okay, this one I bought on Amazon, I can't remember what I paid for it, it wasn't over expensive. The reason why I don't use it is not long enough. This is the one I've been using the most amount of time while being in here. And this one has also been modified, Mum alterated it twice actually to make it the right size. And up here, you probably can't see anyway, there's actually a curtain rail which I put onto the ceiling. It's been moved 3 times already, and that's what I tend to do. And it's great, it does work. But, of course, this sort of material, you get lots of wrinkles. And the amount of times it caught me off guard when it comes to editing stages, I haven't noticed it wasn't 100% flat. So, yeah. So there we go, it's fantastic. And, of course, when I moved my streaming server into here, originally it was actually over there. And I was using a wooden rail, and also where the furniture was at the time, there wasn't a lot of space. So I'd probably lose about a quarter of it. And it was fine, but after about 2 or 3 months, the wooden rail snapped. So I moved all the furniture around, I bought myself a metal rail, extended it, and it works brilliantly. The only problem is why it needs a door. And also, if I'm streaming or I'm recording something, and yes, my chair keeps catching on it. So it's always going to be a problem. And of course, the wrinkles, you've had to iron it a few times, but at the moment time, it seems okay. But in cable time, it has fallen down. But it's time for a change. And hopefully now I've got enough space, it will work. But no longer is it going to be hanging on the ceiling, it's going to be on the ground. Okay, so unboxing time. I can't believe how much this thing weighs as well. But yes, hopefully if my measurements are correct, it will fit in there. If it doesn't, it's going back. But it should do. I'm really impressed with how well it's packed. But the biggest problem we're going to have with this specific one is where it's going to be stored. I'm not using it. It gets really heavy. I can't believe it. Didn't actually mean to do that, but there we go. Yeah, it looks like I'm holding a great big massive bazooka. Okay. Right, bingo. Right, so, you open that up. Open that up, like a briefcase. And then it raises. Look at that. Raise and retract. There you go. We're not using it. Get away, and in my case, find somewhere to store it. Okay, currently Sunday the 18th of June 2023. Now unfortunately the green screen had to go back to Amazon. The reason why that was the case is basically it was too large. Now I measured it before I bought it and it would have fit. Unfortunately the description didn't match the actual physical version. The site said it was 148 centimeters, but it was actually 164 centimeters, so no dice. Now I did try it with two tables, one either side, have it slightly higher, but it wasn't going to work with the ceiling. So unfortunately I had to pack it all the way again, which took about an hour, and send it on its way. So I left it in the porch and they collected it 2 days later. So in the meantime, we'll put an end to this video, we'll do a quick unboxing, but this time let's have some games, shall we? Now I have to admit, I've not bought many Amiga games in the last half a year or so. I bought a few, but quite a few of them are replacing ones that got damaged over the years. And as I mentioned earlier in this video, this particular game is one that's got very badly damaged over the years. So I managed to get myself a mintier version. Hopefully it's going to be accurate, unlike the accuracy of the one I bought on Amazon. Okay. Rightio. So there we go, I bought myself a Ninja Box version of Final Fight. As I mentioned earlier in this video, my other one, which I got from the older days, I can't remember the name of the shop, it was a shop in Folkestone, bought it on the same day as Weber Taylor. This one's got really badly crushed over the years. But yeah, much, much better. And yes, it is Swedish House's favourite, it is US Gold. It is a good game, not overly difficult though, I did finish it quite quickly. But yes, this game requires quite a lot of disc swapping. So down are your two discs. And also you've got the manual, which of course on one side is Final Fight, on the other side is Mega Twins, which I know Rusty James got in his collection. And this one does not feature in my other box. There goes Swedish House, feature eyes on that bad boy. US Gold. Yeah. The mark of a winner. So let's see what we've got. Crucible Corpse, Might and Magic 3, Planet's Edge, Shadow Sorcerer, Eye of the Beholder, Their Finest Hour, which I have in my collection over there, Secret of Monkey Island, and Secret of Monkey Island 2. Indiana Jones and the Fate of Atlantis I do have, and Lynx, The Challenge of Golf. And Jet Fighter 2, and also Operation Stealth. There you go, one that Andrew DeBrine also likes. But there we go, fantastic. So I'm really happy with that. Nice addition to the collection, and it's another one I've ticked off the list to replace that is damaged. Okay, boy, that's more than a foot here. So I do apologize for how long this video has been, but originally I did start it in March. It's been a long time going. But anyway, it wasn't really going to be 16, but that's the way it turned out. But hopefully you enjoyed it. But please like and comment. You can find me on most platforms. Something more than games, you find it fairly easy. Please remember to hit the bell icon and notify your videos. That'd be fantastic. I changed that slightly. A lot of videos like this, if you haven't been making live streams on Friday night, you can tell your favorite clock at the start of a week. And long play, it's a bit last. It's a bit gobbledygook, this one. Anyway, take it easy. Ciao, bye, see ya.